What is
All
it?
right, please tell me when it's up again.
What is the game doing? I restarted it. I just had to change the game.
Oh, okay.
Okay, and I'm gonna
Oh,
tweet about
yeah.
this because I'm seeking attention from the internet.
Oh, follow Hitbox on Twitter. Oh yeah, that's right. I'm not even logged in on the site right now.
Yeah, if you wanna participate to the chat.
Okay, what was my login for this site again? I kind of forgot.
Well, you better not. I don't remember. I have the chat. Okay, this looks fine. I could have
Oh,
crammed
okay.
this a bit
Somehow I
more because
remembered.
the game doesn't use the whole window, but whatever. You'll get little black bands. I'm too lazy to crop this. Alrighty. OBS already has enough trouble detecting stuff sometimes. I probably should tell it to not pick up my mouse. Got your mouse cursor? No, please. There we go. No, do I have to restart this
Yeah, the
again?
delay is indeed better. It's like it's about 5 seconds.
Oh, whatever. I'm not gonna put my mouse on the screen that often.
All right. Chris is here in order to show you the tutorial on how to shoot a zombie and climb on a box.
I can probably close this. Is this New Game Plus or just New Game? Excellent question, actually. I was gonna say. What the hell is it doing? Dolphin is resizing the window automatically for some reason. I don't know why.
Okay.
Is it gonna look like that? Because if it continues, I have no. Okay, I don't know why I did that, but whatever. I hope it doesn't. It's not going to resize it again for the gameplay because I'm gonna have to change that.
Oh.
Oh well, that's not a big deal. Yes, this is going to be a New Game Plus. When you finish the game under certain conditions, like you have to finish it under 5 hours, I think, and there's all this stuff, like the difficulty you're playing on. I don't remember all the conditions, but depending on the conditions, you finish the game, you unlock a number of things. Like real survival, which makes it so your objects do not teleport from box to box.
Oh
Or
boy.
invisible enemy, which makes all the enemies invisible, if I remember correctly. I think
Wait,
that's
didn't
what it
you tell
is.
me like about an enemy that followed you all around the game and was impossible to kill or something?
I think so, but I don't think that's that. I don't know. I don't remember. I don't play these modes because they're annoying. We're just gonna play once again, which basically is just the normal game. But some of the stuff we unlocked is still going to appear. And I suppose we might as well play on hard.
Oh boy.
Resident Evil.
Oh, is the game loud enough? I don't know. I already have Dolphin lowered a bit, maybe a little too bit lowered. Right, so we're playing Chris. That sounds too loud. I should have tested this before. And the window resized itself again.
Alpha team is flying around the forest zone, situated in northwest Raccoon City, where we are searching for the helicopter of our compatriots, Bravo team, who disappeared during the middle of their
Chris, you
mission.
haven't found it yet?
No, not yet, Brent.
Bizarre
And now
murder
for a
cases
special
have
news
recently occurred in Raccoon City.
bizarre murders in our
There are
city
outlandish
continue to
reports of
escalate.
families being attacked by
Words
a
have
group of
just come
about
in
10
with
people.
friends camping in the woods
Victims
have been
were
killed.
apparently eaten. The Bravo team was sent in to investigate, but we lost contact.
Look, Chris!
Bravo Team's helicopter was a derelict. Save for the remaining body of Kevin. We continued our search for the other members, and it turned into a nightmare.
Alright, I'm back. Just had a phone call.
You missed somebody getting killed by dogs.
Oh yeah, that's right. That's the genuine intro of the game.
That is the genuine intro, yeah. And Jill either forgot to load her gun or is just...
I like puppies!
I don't know, I have to say I really like the intro of the original Kimball
yeah, like,
War
like
so
it better,
far.
But this one is... This one is competently made, I guess, which makes it kind of boring.
Yeah, because all the charm of the previous thing was because it was completely incompetent. All of the dogs, for free!
You can't force B-movie charm, though.
There are only 3 STARS members left now.
Enter Captain the survival Wester, horror. And myself. In a door that... Okay, OBS, what are you doing?
Now it's Dolphin.
Is everyone alright?
Barry. Where's Barry?
He's...
No. What was that?
I'll go and check it out.
All right. Jill and I will stay and secure this area.
Chris? Take care.
Yeah.
Oh boy. Dolphin by default auto-resized the window to rendering resolution, which apparently changes between cutscenes and gameplay.
Oh,
that's fantastic.
Boy.
I'm gonna have to turn that off.
Alright.
It's smaller than I thought it would be. For gameplay. Okay. Option. Graphics. Auto-adjust window size. Do not do that, please. There we go. Okay, technical difficulty over.
All right.
So holy shit! I forgot how to move in tank patrols. You may notice something unusual.
Okay. Yeah. Why do you have this gun this early in the game?
We have an infinite ammo rocket launcher.
Oh.
This is going to make things much simpler, much less tedious, and I won't have to worry about carrying weapons because, overwhelmed in my inventory because I just have one weapon that is going to be there for the whole time, and I can just devote all 5 other, squares to key items or healing. I do not care if it's cheap or easy, I don't give a shit. I just want to show the cutscenes and shit.
Oh no, black guy that never got introduced.
Boom, the zombie's dead. Never got a chance.
I hope he's gonna come back in order to close the door.
Oh, I have to report back. I can't just speedrun this. Whatever.
Sir, there was a zombie. I shot it with a grenade launcher.
Right, so the
thing should ask Barry to go look at the blood.
Normally, instead of the rocket launcher, you don't have a gun, you just have a knife. Chris starts with no gun. Which doesn't make sense, because he had a gun during the cutscene, but whatever.
Wesker? Jill? Where did they go?
Oh no, where did they go? They disappeared. And Jill's gun is on the floor. And that's when Chris gets a gun, which we will not be taking because that is worthless. Right. What is this?
A door.
What are you doing? Get out. Did you say anything else? I don't know if I banned someone who was trying to be helpful or just plug in another channel.
Oh yeah, he was plugging low-tech stream.
Oh, that was just low-tech stream?
Yeah.
I don't know if that was a good idea to ban that person, actually. Maybe that was mean. Okay, unban. I didn't pay attention, I just saw a URL to another channel, I'm like, what are you doing? This stream is already going great. I'm being the nicest person to the audience.
The survival horror. What a terrible night for a chat.
Oh, hello, zombie. Goodbye, zombie.
But wait, does that kill the zombies forever?
No,
or...
I think they can still come back, but it's not like I care.
Oh. Where's your critical rockets when you need them?
I don't know if the rocket launcher does critical hits. I don't think it really matters, though. There's no knife here, what? Chris gets even less, or maybe it's because I'm on hard. There should also be a zombie here, but there's none. What the hell? There's just little differences that are kind of weird between Chris and Jill. Like, sometimes, for some reason, there's less zombies or something.
Too bad that you cannot simply destroy the statue by shooting at it.
Oh, maybe I should have tried.
Probably would not have worked.
I don't know.
Honestly, I don't think the game expects you to have a rocket launcher at this point of the game.
No, of course not. I mean, it's a bonus. It's a New Game Plus bonus.
Uh-oh.
Honestly, forget what you have to do exactly to get it because I just downloaded a save file.
Oh.
I'm not, like, it requires you to finish the game multiple times under a certain number of hours and specific. I'm like, I'm done doing this. I've done enough of this on my actual GameCube when I was a kid. Like, that's enough.
Yeah, that just reminds me of how I pretty much replayed the Worms Armageddon camping over and over again when I will just want to unlock the stuff.
Why would you do that?
I don't know, because I kind of like the single player.
I do not like Worms Armageddon single player, or any Worms single player really, I just don't see the point. It's not fun for me.
Yeah, it's essentially a glorified training mode.
Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I guess in some parts, some of the maps weren't too bad, kind of puzzle-ish, but most of the time it's just not fun. Gotta examine the book to get the key. I'm not even gonna bother examining the key. Whatever.
Yeah, at this point we already know everything.
It's the sword key. I know this game by heart.
With that said, I'm gonna laugh if you somehow end up dying despite having an overpowered, unlimited supply weapon.
I doubt it'll happen. There's not many things that can insta-kill you, and... I mean, they're not very... I know why they appear, so it's not like anything's gonna surprise me.
Oh, and yeah, by the way, I might be sniffling through the course of the stream, but that's because I have the T-virus.
And not because of allergies.
Oh, absolutely not.
I wonder if the knife training zombie is still there. Probably. Let's see.
Yeah, if there's a knife, there's going to be a knife tutorial.
Yeah, the dagger, a knife tutorial, whatever. Also, there's another unlockable that we're gonna get. This is a special kind of unlockable that we can't get. Like, it doesn't appear in our inventory at the beginning. But we're gonna get it soon.
Why are you tripping? You have a fucking rocket launcher!
Yeah, I don't... tripping. Falling on the floor, on your ass like a dummy. Right. Oh no, the window shattering.
What could that mean?
Right, I want to try something, because I always thought you just had to go in this corridor twice before the hunters appear, but someone said you just have to go through that corridor the other way for that event to happen.
Alright,
oh,
let's experiment.
They were right. Well, good on you.
Oh my god, this segment of the game is so scary!
Thanks. Psych.
You're welcome.
It's locked, and that's where Chris is annoying. He doesn't have the lockpick. He has to find little Zelda keys.
Yep. Welcome to the Legend of Zelda. Oh, fuck yes, Chris is also a fan of emptying dirty water.
Well, yeah, there's the exact same number of tubs, and we have to get them all.
Who's trying to take my bat?
Also, for some reason, this cutscene does not kill the zombie, unlike with Jill.
Oh, okay.
No, okay, I wasn't sure. I thought I injured myself.
And then Chris goes to puke in the toilet.
No, Chris is a man, come on. He doesn't have a stomach.
He's a man! He's rewarded with an old key!
Yay, instead of a knife. So unlike Jill, who could just skip that room and speedrun, Chris has to go in inside.
So is there any reason why you can't use the same old key like twice, or...?
No, I can only use it once. It's a small key. It's like Zelda. You use it on a door, and then it disappears.
Oh my god.
Unlike the mansion key, the sword key, which opens all the doors with a sword. So in there... Actually, I'm gonna check what's in there, because there might be a key. I do not remember where all the small keys are. But otherwise, in there, there's the... a shotgun, but we're not gonna take that. We don't need it. There's a knife. Or a dagger. And I don't see anything else.
You take the dagger!
That's the shotgun, but we don't care. Because it would trigger the trap.
Yep. And... yeah.
And Barry does not see this.
Yep.
Chris does have another character that acts as his partner, but... we won't see that character for a little while.
Oh boy. it's now time for true survival horror. You're all alone.
Yep. Hello, goodbye.
Bye. Like there was four people entering the mansion and were left with none.
Alright, so when you are on New Game Plus, I have an infinite handgun also, I forgot about that. Hold on.
Oh, and a closet key.
Just want to check this. This list looks different. Right, this is like, before getting the rocket launcher, this is the main weapon that you can get to clear the higher difficulties. It's an infinite handgun that shoots three times in burst of threes. It's actually pretty good.
Yeah.
Against little zombies. Survival knife. Does Chris's look different? Maybe. I don't know. Whatever. It's crap. And also, you notice there's this key that wasn't there before.
Oh yeah, the closet key.
Closet key, the design of a... sure, okay.
And it's beautifully the word that begins with a E.
And we could burn the zombies, but who cares?
Yeah, we don't have a lighter yet.
No, we do have the lighter, actually, if you look at the top right. This is, instead of the, lockpick, this is Chris's, permanent item.
Oh.
We do have the lighter.
Okay, but even then, the lighter is still way more situational than, say, the lockpick.
Yes.
I mean, couldn't he have just, like, the grenade launcher as his alternate item or something?
Well, that would be too easy. That is the second floor map. I do not need to pick that up, because I know where everything is. Hopefully. It's a GLLP and a Chris stream, yes. Dog whistle, we're gonna get, blah blah blah.
Gonna whistle in the dog and we're gonna shoot the rocket. No, that's not how it works.
I don't care about that. What do you have to say about the... Oh, it has the exact same description. I was thinking, do they have different things to think about chess?
I just expected him to be like, oh, what is this?
Okay. I think we've got everything we need from here. I don't know why I went through that door. It would've been faster the other way. Chris, are you drunk? Okay, so we're gonna use that key that we just found to unlock, to get our new unlockable. I think you're gonna like this one.
Oh boy.
Right, so you remember in the last video we recorded, the note that said something about a painting in an art room and something behind?
Oh yeah.
So like I know about this place, but I never realized that's what the note was talking about. Like for some reason I never clicked. But in this room there's a painting here and the key that opens it. And we don't need the key.
Oh, okay.
Because it's a painting and it's an art room, but for some reason I never clicked that this is what the note was talking about. And in here there's alternate costumes.
Oh yes.
On this side there's another star uniforms which looks boring. And on the other side there's street type costume.
Oh boy.
And
here's
the
dressing
room.
We
are now effectively a Saints Row character. We're gonna play the rest of the game like this.
Too bad that he's not purple, though.
Yeah, well, you can't have everything, I guess.
Go Red Team!
I don't know if we're Johnny Gat. If anything, he looks more like Carlos. No, I will not stream Resident Evil Zero. Do not ask about Resident Evil Zero. Fuck that game. No.
Wait, is it that bad, or...?
It's really bad. Oh, jeez, this one is fast.
Yeah.
Wait, what? Oh, shit! Wait a minute.
Oh.
Hold on!
Okay.
What?
You got killed by an invisible zombie, boy.
Fuck, this is... Oh, fuck. I thought you had to select a special mode. I didn't think that would be in the New Game Plus by default. Why is one dangerous zombie on? Why? What? Fuck. I have to replay all of this.
Oh god. Alright, I guess we're gonna use saves from now on.
Forest is in New Game Plus no matter what. Fuck! I thought this was not the case!
Resident Evil.
Maybe it's because I selected hard, which is why I selected it again, because I'm an idiot.
Oh my god.
Skip.
There are only three.
I'm sorry.
Enter the survival horror again.
And the whole point I started the stream early is because I knew this would take a while. I am the best at video games, you guys. Great. So basically that means this guy is gonna appear randomly. And
yep. So yeah, if we see a fast zombie, we run the fuck away.
Great!
No, and my 3DS has to do an update!
Oh no. What are you playing?
I don't know. I just booted it up in the meantime that you do all of your...
Oh yeah, so just say that my stream is boring. Why don't you just say that to my face?
Nah.
Just be honest, come on. I deserve that.
Yeah, after all, it took like 5 minutes or something.
Shit. Wesker? Jill?
I spilled my drink! On the controller. No.
Oops.
Wait, which way? This way, first. Because I gotta get the angel, arrow. Oh boy.
Yeah, but Carlos is not supposed to die that fast.
Well, it's a very abridged version of Saints Row, too.
He had a very long death scene that started right in the intro.
Defense weapons, at least the daggers, should be okay against Carlos. I don't know if the other defense weapon that Chris can get is okay. Because Chris does not get batteries like Jill, he gets a different kind, which is awesome, but I don't want to spoil that.
Uh-oh.
So yeah, I guess we're gonna be saving regularly now.
So, essentially, if you get raged by Forrest, it's an instant kill, right?
Okay, I'm not entirely sure, because I played like this. I played that mode, like, once, and I was like, this is dumb.
Oh.
But I think, basically, he basically acts like a fast zombie. Shooting him makes him explode. And the only thing that does not make him explode is a dagger, I think.
Uh-huh.
But, like, if he attacks you, you don't have a dagger, he just deals the damage that a normal zombie would deal. So it doesn't kill you.
Okay, but do they ever explain why attacking him kills you, however?
Because he's covered with grenades. So when you shoot him, he explodes.
Oh. But does he explode so hard that he nukes the entire world, or...?
Well, the entire mansion, I suppose, I assume. Or something.
Ah, okay, he's covered with grenades.
That's what I said.
And essentially, we shot him with like 3-4 grenade launcher shots.
I don't see why... Shit, I keep pressing buttons too hard. No, shit. Ah!
Wait.
I forget how to use this inventory system. Why did I... Oh my god.
Wait, apparently a secondary item to defend himself is to shove grenades in people's faces?
No, I don't... I'm out.
Right, we better make him a moderator.
Mister, I said I didn't want to spoil it. Can we please keep up with what I'm saying? Thankfully, you're not reading the chat, I hope.
I saw the latest message that he did. And yeah, I am not able to ban anyone because I don't have mod powers.
I don't have mod power. I should give you that. If you post a message, I can probably give you that.
Oh. Alright. Oh, Smite, get away. Alright, here's the most informative message that I can think of.
There we go. Right, we're gonna get back to where we were in no time.
You are now a moderator and channel Paul Rangi.
I was planning on uploading this to YouTube, but I don't know if I should leave the whole thing. What are you doing? Oh no, Windows.
Right. I think we've done about half of the progress that we did so far.
Hey, Zom. Why do you have invincibility frames?
Oh god.
This is bullshit.
Okay, at least it doesn't seem as if you took any damage.
I don't think so. I think it's just a little animation where you're too close, but it's not
actually... The zombie is invincible!
Invincible. Yeah, this is the nice thing about Hitbox, there's practically no lag for the video. I like Hitbox. I think I may just stream on this site from now on. Even though a lot of people are subscribed to me on Twitch, I don't think I care about that.
You're abandoning all of your followers!
No, I don't think killing a zombie with the rocket launcher prevents them from being Crimson Head. I forgot to pick up a thing. I'm dumb. I'm going too fast. I'm trying to go too fast. No, I don't think it doesn't. They will become Crimson Heads because, I mean, if they were dead, their body would disappear, and that's not the case. trying to go too fast, I'm wasting time because I'm forgetting stuff.
Know what you have to do in order to go faster.
Man, if I were on games done quickly, this would be the worst. You think they're doing Resident Evil and on that?
Why not?
I mean, it is a game you can speedrun. There's a couple.
I mean, there are people who speedrun like Final Fantasy VI or whatever, so. But why wouldn't they speedrun this game too?
Well, I'm just wondering if it's on the schedule of games done, awesome games done quickly.
I don't know, I never really watch that stuff. Speedruns are just not my forte.
Some of them are interesting, like the way they break the game entirely are pretty sweet.
Oh man, you can follow yourself on hitbox.
I think that's just an oversight.
When they say that the biggest fan of a person is himself.
That's called narcissism. I think one of my favorite speedrun was a Zelda Ocarina of Time speedrun where the guy does a really weird thing that teleports him from Goma to Ganon.
What?
I don't know how he does it, but he manipulates the game into teleporting him there. Basically, from the first boss to the final boss.
Yeah, it's like I kind of remember seeing like a Zelda 2 speedrun or something, which pretty much broke the entire game inside out.
Thank you, Mayday. We just play video games and shut up. None of that talking over video bullshit. Man, remember QuickTime? Remember what a piece of garbage that's always been?
Oh yeah. I especially learned that when I did my Prince of Persia 3D LP because the game itself required... Yeah, because the game required you to install QuickTime in order to be able to run the cutscenes. Otherwise, the moment the cutscene would load, the game will freeze.
Well, yeah, because the game wouldn't understand, why can't I just open QuickTime? It's bullshit.
Yeah. It's like I had to install like an old-ass version of it just in order to make everything work. So I think I needed to use like a QuickTime Alternate or something.
Mm-hmm. Man, I have a couple games, old games, that require QuickTime and are the sole reason why I can't run them anymore. Annoying.
I hope they're all as good as Subversia 3D.
I would say some of them are interesting. Like there's a game that's called The Daedalus Encounter that actually Super Great Friend streamed it, which is an FMV game, so it's not like it's not great, but it's kind of fascinating. But I'm fairly sure it requires QuickTime or something.
Oh.
Although Super Great Friend played it on, I think it was the 3DO, and which is, I didn't know there was a 3DO version, so maybe I should,
I didn't even know that people even own a 3DO, period. It's Forest.
He probably used an emulator. Alright, well, at least he reappeared at the same exact place this time. I don't think I took the right door. No, this is not where I want to go.
Unfortunately, this forest just took way too literally the meaning of RUN, FOREST, RUN!
You just stole the chat's joke.
Yeah, I just realized it the moment I read the chat.
I don't believe you, I think you just stole it.
No?
Ah, shit, I need a small key. job. Good job, Ragni. God damn it.
Oh.
There we go.
Oh my god.
Look, it's difficult to aim, okay?
It's difficult to kill enemies with the best weapon of the game.
Well, just... an old-fashioned lock... what? I need more small keys, great. Lock. I need armor key. Where are all the small keys? Maybe there's one in there. This is gonna be... fantastic. Oh my god. I just had a thought. One of the small keys has to be... in the kitchen.
Oh boy.
That's the only place I can think of. I haven't played Chris's playthrough in a while for the specific reason getting all the fucking keys is a pain. Man, I was planning on going as far as at least where we are in the LP. But at this rate, I'm thinking I might just stop before that. I'm certainly not playing the whole game during the stream. There's no fucking way. Well, maybe I should have picked up the map. Because then I could just check the rooms. The map tells you which room have stuff in them. Although considering I'm not picking up weapons and herbs, it wouldn't help much. Is that a thing I saw? No, it's nothing. Although if someone wants to check a guide and tell me where the small keys are, I'd be fine with that.
Alright. How does that do this do the work?
What are you doing? There's gotta be a key in the kitchen, because I can't think of any other place to go right now.
Alright, is there like a key fact or something?
I don't know. Most facts are really just gonna describe what you do need to do in which order.
Oh.
There you go, that's a key. I knew there was a key.
Oh, that's why I like how come every single one of these keys are... Oh, holy shit.
New content. Yeah, if you go in the kitchen and then come back, this happens. It doesn't happen if you wait too long, like the part where we're in the LP. And there's...
Oh, you're surrounded! Never mind.
What is that noise?
Maybe it's the zombie that was crawling on the floor.
Oh, there was... I did not even notice that. Wow. The room was too dark. I did not notice the zombie there.
I have the eyes of a sphinx.
Good job. Okay, so now, which way am I going? I think this way might be shorter. Now we're gonna get the whistle. We're gonna whistle the dogs.
Alright. That will be like at the place where you normally meet Forrest, but now Forrest has a new mission.
Fuck you, crows!
Really shoot at crows with a and you miss?
I didn't miss, I killed like probably 4 out of 6. Explosion isn't that big. There we go.
Oh. You might be able to unlock this with a key that will break immediately.
Yeah, this mansion was well designed, wasn't it? With, you know, I was asking the question, who went around, after the zombie apocalypse happened? Who went around and locked all the doors and activated all the traps? But now it- oh shit. What am I doing?
Oh.
Fuck! Chris, come on!
Good thing you have an unlimited grenade launcher.
Yeah, also Chris has a fuck ton of HP. He does not die.
Yeah, what the fuck? You're still fine!
I'm still in the green. I think it still counts as damage, like it just doesn't show you what you had, but... But yeah, it takes quite a while before Chris's health go into yellow.
Yeah, or red.
Alright, so I got the color, meaning I have... no, not combine. I have to go in the room with the armor key.
Right, the legend of Carlos continues.
Carlos San Diego. Hello, fast zombie. Goodbye, oh wait, he's not dead. He's in? No? Oh yes, he's dead, okay.
Yeah, he just really took his time.
Had to fall in a dramatic way for some reason.
Oh yeah, that's right. We need to extend the fake key. Oh no, what are we going to do? Oh my goodness, oh, okay.
A well-designed trap.
Yep. The trap's so nice, we designed it like 3 or 4 times in the mansion.
My nose is also running. I'm sorry. It's not allergies, though.
It's the T-virus.
Oh no!
One of us!
Now I got the armor key, what do I do? This isn't Resident Evil 5, I don't think you're gonna see a boulder. Ooh, a zombie! Oh shit, it's forest!
Oh, hello!
I was gonna shoot it, because this happens... well, this happened in the LP, but it was a different zombie. I think we're gonna save.
That would be a plan.
Normally there is an ink ribbon by default in the chest and it's not there. Okay, so I guess we're not saving.
There's no ink ribbon in the room?
Nope. Okay, then we're gonna do something different. I'm missing an item. To go in the dining room first. I need the
blue gem. Wasn't there ink there?
Wait,
or it's a normal thing?
The blue gem just gives me shotgun shells. I don't need to do that. Fuck the blue gem. speedrunning this shit. We're late already on the schedule.
Alright, plan puzzle.
No, there's no schedule, I'm joking.
At 19 p.m. we were supposed to be killing the giant snake!
Also, you know what? This is how confident I feel about this. I'm gonna burn all the herbs. I don't need to use this anymore, wow, okay. Bam, all the herbs are dead.
Congratulations, you are no Captain Planet.
Fuck nature. Okay. Oh no, zombies! We don't even need to check Itchy and Scratchy. Okay.
Ranchi's not gonna die. Why waste the time?
Might as well use the key in that door just to open it.
I'm sorry, dear Oops. Chad, but I don't really think that you can compare Ragni to Corn Shack.
I clicked too many times. Who's Corn Shack?
Oh, he's the guy in that one early Red Supre who was talking a whole lot.
That's not very precise.
I'm gonna play as Luigi. Why? Because I can't waste time dying.
I mean, lots of people talk a lot in Red Supres. Or...
Oh, he's like the Grand Classic.
Pick that up.
Alright, we have a save game. Oh, three save games, holy shit.
Yeah, each ink ribbon contains three.
Okay.
It's not like... It's always like this. Alright, so what am I doing now? Because I'm doing things out of the order I'm used to, which is Jill's. I'm gonna open that just to use the key. But there's nothing there. If you go in Forest's room, you don't get the rocket launcher with Chris. It just does not happen.
Does not happen in the Chris playthrough,
no.
Or just not in that mode where runs
Chris,
around?
Chris does not get the grenade launcher. That's just a thing. That's how it works.
Okay.
Which is a pain, because it's a useful weapon. Oh, hey!
So is the...
Look at that.
You.
Oh, Chris Redfield.
Alpha Team, we're here to rescue you. Richard, what the hell happened to you? Chris, this place... Get your team out of here. Demons... everywhere.
Don't talk. He seems to have been bitten by a poisonous snake, but the size of the bite mark is huge.
It's not just any ordinary snake. Take my word for it.
He needs serum. I left it in another room.
I'll go get it.
Why did you leave your own serum?
I'll be back.
Aren't you the medic? She's supposed to be the medic in this whole STARS thing. Why wouldn't she be carrying this stuff on her all the time? Also, I forgot about this, but I guess changing Chris's costume also changes her costume. Because she doesn't look like that usually. She has a uniform, kind of. So we gotta get the serum, this is the exact same, quest. I think I'm gonna go this way. Oh wait, I forgot to unlock it. Never mind!
Yeah, it's locked from the other side.
Yeah, that was Rebecca. Chris's partner. She's Chris's partner in this playthrough. And also, she's useless.
Yeah, it's like, why didn't we see her whatsoever until like now?
No, she's, oh shit. Forrest, no. Leave me alone.
My name's Forrest. Oh. Forrest Gale.
No, no, Chris, this one. Alright, no, shit. We're doing this!
This is kind of pandemonium right now. Oh, at least Forrest doesn't seem to understand how stairs work.
Alright, oh shit, you know what? Am I gonna have enough time to come back? I'm still gonna save. I've never saved.
Yeah, but don't you have like a generous time limit for that?
Yes, normally. Oh god, look at this red font.
Welcome to the drug room.
God, he's in the way. This is gonna be stupid. I'm gonna probably have to use a knife dagger.
Whoa! You should stab one of.
Good job, Forrest.
Oh.
What are you doing?
How does the railing work? Help.
Oh boy, this is fun. I love this game.
Yeah, I have a feeling I'm gonna like this mode.
I didn't think this mode would activate. I completely forgot.
Yeah, but honestly, I think so far it's warranted. I like this.
Right. Okay, I hope I'm not late. Please don't be late, because if I'm late, I miss a really good cutscene.
Hope this is what you wanted.
Thank you.
Alright,
we're good. I'm gonna give you a shot now, Richard. Hang in there.
Here, take it. It's a radio. Take care of yourself, Rebecca. Richard!
He's okay. He's just unconscious.
Rebecca, it's not safe here. Let's get Richard to a safer place.
Right.
Right, so unlike with Jill, who just leaves him here, they move him?
Richard's doing well, Chris. He should recover soon.
Good. Richard needs you now.
As soon as Richard gets better, we'll come after you.
Rebecca, you okay with a gun?
Yes.
All right. I'm gonna continue my investigation.
Be careful. Okay?
Yeah. So if I remember correctly, if you go back into that room, that safe room, you can just talk to Rebecca and she'll heal you for free.
Oh, that's nice.
I mean, yeah, considering Chris has the most health.
Hi, Forrest, how you doing?
Hello. You know, it's not quite as nice as letting you bypass a trap or two.
Yeah.
Like Barry. I don't know, it's different, I guess. That's... oh wait, wrong door. Where am I going? Yeah, we'll be safe here, Forrest will protect us. Because they went into the one safe room. They couldn't go into the other safe room that was closer. That would have been too much work.
Oh yeah, that's right. Now we're going to fight this snake, and now I guess we're not gonna have any.
There's a guy here. What? Use your knife. Why am I not using my knife? Do I not? Oh, I guess I forgot to pick them up. Right.
Oh yeah. No, that I think I think that's because you used them all on the dogs.
Did I? Well, anyway, I don't have any knife right now, so that's great.
Oh, hey, you took damage this time.
Yeah. Come on.
Alright, it's snake time.
Nope. No, you're forgetting a whole bunch of puzzles you have to do first before going there.
I thought that the door leading behind led you right to the snake immediately.
Yes, but you need the shield key, and to get the shield key, you need to...
Oh yeah, that room.
You need to get the golden emblem and put it in the place of the normal emblem in the dining room. And to get the golden emblem, you need the music sheet that is in here.
Yeah. Where you need to light the light. Oh,
what the fuck is he doing here? What? What?
Stealth Forest!
This is bullshit!
Okay, Forest is the best protagonist.
God fucking damn it!
So, how did he end up here?
What the fuck?
I don't understand!
This game is garbage! Oh shit!
Yeah, now Forest is back here. Oh no!
Let me go. Ah. Just let me walk. You mean person. I didn't expect him to just appear there. I thought it was gonna be the normal zombie. Great, I have to do this whole thing again. Why did I decide to stream this?
But because it was going to be so...
Because it would be tedious.
Hey, we're gonna make it easy by having an unlimited grenade launcher and by having a protagonist which insta-kills you the moment you attack.
Stupid fucking game. Right, skip cutscene. No one cares. Yeah, I guess I should get...
Richard.
Yeah, whatever. I've been wounded, I should probably heal. Rebecca, heal me.
This room is equipped with all sorts of medical supplies. I could pretty much treat any wound. Want me to treat your wounds?
Can you treat an explosion to the face?
Would you?
Sorry.
My explosion just hurt my arm a little bit.
I think I'm gonna, if this continues, I'm gonna end up using save states instead of normal. What's the shortcut for save state in this?
This is the fucking pro-ass Resident Evil run I've ever seen.
Hold on. All right, I get it. No, because if I have, like, there is a limited number of, of save things, and if I run out, or if I use too much, or stuff like that, hello, Forest.
Oh my god, this fucking wall is in the way again.
Oh, please, no. Let's not even imagine what, Resident...
Oh, yeah. Kaizo Resident Evil.
Resident Kaizo.
No, Resident Kaizo.
Kaizo Evil. No. Or...
Dogs with grenades. I have
Forest,
kind of a feeling
Forest
of deja vu here.
Forest is a dog.
It's just like, that reminds me of that one time where I decided to hack a Red Alert and just decided to make it so that the dogs became the toughest enemy of the game, and instead of just biting you, they breathed fire in your face.
Wait, you can do that?
Yeah.
You can mod the game to do that?
Yeah. It's like I had this one program that I ended up buying at a computer store for like $5, which just allow you to tweak any single aspect of the game. And the first thing that I did
wait, where do you buy a program to hack Red Alert 2? Was it 2?
Nah, it was just at a small computer shop of my town.
But like never mind.
Yeah, just be reminded, that was back before the internet was a thing.
Alright, Forrest, are you in there? Shit, he is.
My name's Forrest.
At least
Forrest
the game is... Gale. Forrest, come on. Don't be an asshole. Pick up that quickly. Am I gonna have time to escape? Yes! You idiot!
Is there a way that you can... Oh wait, didn't you have to light the room in order to see things, or...?
Yes, I did that.
Oh, okay.
If you didn't notice, I lit up the candle to see what's actually in the room.
Oh, that's right, because now you don't have to switch to your inventory in order to do that, Hope.
I get the feeling Forrest's appearances are not actually random. But I just have no idea where he's gonna appear, because I've never done this before. Right, music sheet.
Oh yeah, don't we have to find the second half of the thing?
The second half is in the room with the piano. I'm just thinking.
Oh.
Maybe I want to do this first because it's right next to where I am. I don't know. I don't know if that would have been faster, actually.
Yeah, the armor pushing puzzle.
Yeah, fascinating, isn't it?
It's like, I still don't understand what is the connection between giant suits of armor and poisonous gas that is sprayed all over if you do the puzzle wrong.
I don't think there's a connection, it's just there's a puzzle and a trap that activates it if you don't do the puzzle, that's it.
And here we...
Oh my god. I was about to sneeze, but it never came true.
I hate when that happens.
Yep. Right, and now, box opening puzzle.
Da-na-na-na. I'm not gonna bother editing anything because I'm lazy.
Oh yeah, because we need to edit out this masterpiece of a video.
I mean, you know, maybe I could just cut the part where I walk back to a place after getting killed by this stupid asshole.
Wait, is he dead? Oh, okay.
For some reason they're definitely
Yes, that's how it should happen. Whenever you'll have put the four dead mask, it will be Forrest inside the coffin.
That would be a problem, because the coffin, the door will not... When the coffin opens, the door to the crypt closes, and you have to kill the zombie inside to make it open.
Time to dump some dead mask.
Oh, there's an old key in there. I forgot about that. I did not notice it earlier.
And might as well save our progress. With save states and Ink Ribbon, we can do everything.
I mean, I'll try to not use save state, but if I have to...
because of a certain you-know-who.
Yes, you. Right, because of
I will kill you, Chris Hetfield. I will kill you with my mind.
So in Chris's playthrough, it's Wesker who leaves stuff for you.
Oh, he's so kind.
Yeah, he's really nice.
I just disappeared for no reason, but hey, have some bullets.
I don't think there's anything essential we need, but I would just want to show something. In there, I mean. An old key, well, I do have an old key.
Might be just, able to unlock.
Yeah, all this stuff, the stuff you get in there is for the Magnum, but we don't need that, because we have the best weapon already. But, in here, you remember that letter that was torn? It was missing the first part. Well, when you play as Chris, the first part is still there. It's not torn off.
Okay.
Although,
essentially, Chris is a librarian.
I don't... Although the thing is, I don't think any of this actually really says anything. Oh yeah, I guess no. You do find out that there was an accident, and there was an accident. There was a lab, and there was an accident, and a virus leaked. This part you don't find it out with Jill. It's hidden. So you sort of get spoiled on the story.
Essentially, Chris is the brains of the operation. He gets all of the lore.
A disease called flu.
How coincidental that before this, I just ended up watching the Arise Ritsu Praise again.
Oh god, why did you watch that? I think I played those games on Newgrounds before even watching that Ritsu Praise, because I was bored out of my mind. I played a lot of
Newgrounds games. Welcome to JPEGs.exe.
I played a lot of Newgrounds games back when I had no money. I mean, even less than now. Right, so now...
Alright, so what's next on the agenda? Oh yeah,
the
that's
piano.
Right, we're
oh
looking
my
for
God.
The piano room.
You know what, I just remembered something about the piano, and I should've gone there first, now that I think about it.
Uh-oh.
And you'll see why. This is the problem.
At least his doors unlock permanently now.
Yeah. This is the problem with me playing a character I have not played in many, many years. I don't remember stupid shit.
Back in my old time, I remember when I was Chris Hedfield. Wait, is this his name or?
Redfield.
Oh.
Not Hedfield. Good job, Ty. Okay, so this is the piano room. Also, I heard a door slam, and I'm afraid Forrest is gonna come out of it.
Here, let me play the piano for you. Hi.
It's Deadfield. Right, the other part of the music shit is right there. So, yep. Do you remember what I told you about this puzzle in Chris?
Oh yeah, that's right. Chris doesn't know how to play the piano.
Exactly. So how do you think this is going to be solved?
Oh, you're going to have to go meet Rebecca to ask her to play the piano for you.
You should turn up the sound.
It's me, Chris.
Rebecca.
That sounded like Moonlight Sonata.
What? How can you tell? This sounded nothing like Moonlight Sonata.
I don't know, I don't really think she plays it too well, neither.
No, and that's the thing that I forgot.
What was that?
My interpretation is off a little. Let me practice for a while.
Let Rebecca practice. Yes, you don't have a choice.
Sure.
I won't.
Fuck this.
Yeah, basically... I'm not entirely sure... if you just have to wait a certain amount of time, or if you just have to go out and go back in. If someone knows. But yeah, she won't actually do it right away. Let me check. No, you're not done. Okay. I think maybe it's a set amount of time.
Yeah, I guess.
So I did that in the entirely wrong order. I should have done that first. Then I should have gone for... There's absolutely nothing else I can do, because I think I got everything.
Oh boy.
There's a forest door, but there's nothing in there. Because there's no grenade launcher for Chris. I need her to get the shield key. There's nothing else I can do. Oh great, and the door is slamming. Or it's just trying to get in. Let me see, maybe if I move a couple rooms away and then come back. Oh, should I go get the emblem? Oh, that's right, I forgot to get the emblem. I even forget the actual thing. I'm bad. This is the most horrible speedrun. What was... That's not a zombie, that's just someone saying "boo" to a microphone. Whoops!
Yeah, too bad. I wanted to try and do my own rendition of Moonlight Sonata, but unfortunately I cannot get my piano software to work while I'm doing commentary at once.
Like, no. Shit. Oh god, fuck. Go away! I'm in the yellow, it's fine. I'll be fine.
Uh-oh.
It's fine. We'll just walk it off. Oh my god, you're not done! What do I have to do? I'll just walk around the mansion, fuck it. I'll get herbs. What is happening? I don't know how I managed to.
Oh, it's Forest! It's Forest! Hello!
Of course it's Forest. It doesn't move that quickly from room to room.
This is fucking great.
Yeah. I love this. I love that I decided to do this.
That was the best idea.
Yeah.
I don't care what anyone says.
Starting this LP was a great idea. I suppose there's...
Oh, it was.
I suppose there's a mask I could get in the meantime, but it's really time inefficient. Oh shit, what is this? Is that Forest? No, that's not Forest. Okay. I wasn't sure. If you're not Forest, fuck off!
Alright, so... Either way, for the time being... Well, no, wait, okay.
What are you doing?
Nah, I don't think I'm gonna be doing anything.
Probably pick up a knife. Dagger. I am literally just killing time.
Yeah.
Is that something I'm not aware of, B-Man? Because I don't remember a boulder as Chris's unique weapon in this game, but then again, I played with Chris so little.
Oh boy.
Blah 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 blah.
Blah 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 bl
cannot skip this little cutscene for some reason. I was thinking in 2 hours I can be at the residence and be done with half of the game.
Alright.
Something. Pick up all the daggers.
Yeah. We might as well just use them to threaten Rebecca to learn the song faster.
Come on, Rebecca. Why are you such a pain? I think there's some herbs over there. I'm gonna pick
it's
them up.
A pain of fun.
So much fun.
Alright, so either way, let's switch back live to Rebecca as she learns how to play Moonlight Sonata.
Oh, what the? Dog! Dog! Why am I hearing myself?
Why am I hearing myself?
Dyke, what are you doing?
Dyke, what are you doing?
Dyke!
Okay, that did not work out well. I kind of forgot...
Okay, I'm not hearing myself anymore.
Yeah, I kind of forgot that if I put stereo mix output, the moment you speak, it will fuck the thing up.
Well, yeah, sure. Oh, hey, more zombies that come out of the window. Bye. Okay.
All right.
Oh, Forrest, no, go away.
You use a mansion key.
How do you teleport all everywhere? This makes no sense.
Nah, he's just very perseverant.
What is this? I think it's this side. And then this. And then. Necklace. Yeah, necklace is purple. And we solve the puzzle. Oh, for fuck's sake!
My name's Forrest. Forrest Gump.
Well, I'm gonna have to say hello to Forrest again, because that stupid fucking door is locked.
Oh.
Hello.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, shit!
And he was... Yeah, he was
right
in
front of the door. Why is there
another
one? Oh! Where did you come from? No, go away!
Oh my god, this is awesome!
I hate this game! This game is fucking garbage!
This game is the best. Hey, Infinite Rocket Launcher will make the game easier!
Yeah! I was right! It did make it easier than if I did not have it.
Forrest is like the best character now.
Also, no, the knife doesn't work against Forrest because I had it and Chris did not use it. Well, that's great. So I was wrong. Even the daggers do not work.
And no Clawblade, you cannot knock him down, because the moment you shoot him, you make him explode and you die with him.
The gimmick is that he's covered with grenades, so if you hurt him in any way, he explodes in your face. Alright, he shouldn't be in this corridor anymore, though.
Oh yeah, that's right. Couldn't you kill him with the survival knife, though?
Somehow, I doubt it.
It's time for an experiment.
Chris! Right. Chris! I think I got it!
Oh, thank God.
I'm so excited about getting it.
Practice makes perfect.
What's this?
Hold on. I'm gonna pick up a tissue.
Yeah, honestly, I think we should just put a best of this stream and put in all of the parts with Forrest in it.
Right, what?
No, I was saying we should do a best of this stream and put all of the parts where Forrest comes in.
Maybe, if I'm not too lazy. I'm really hazy when it comes to making stream highlights. I suppose that's a good idea.
And now it's time for a concert of Rebecca, Moonlight Sonata.
Rebecca does not even care that I just got trapped. Eh. Whatever.
Were you alright in there?
Yeah.
She's just like...
Were you alright in there? She has a look of concern in her eyes.
Oh yeah, she looks so concerned.
Fuck. Dodging him is
not... Hello!
Especially in that tiny, tiny, tiny corridor. Where am I going now? Right, the spider. No, wait. Snake.
Oh, and if you have herbs to use, you probably should use them because you're not looking too good.
I do not.
Right, it's time to put in the fire emblem again.
No.
This joke's so bad we had to use it twice.
Yeah. This is why I shouldn't have poisoned the herbs. Yeah, I got overconfidence. those herbs were too many to pick up, anyway. Mention key.
Alright. And now it's time for Ragni to travel back in time in order to unpoison the herbs by killing himself in the past.
I think I'll swing by to the same roof, safe room first, maybe. Or no, wait, there's a couple of There's a couple of herbs in there.
All right, is that a forest room?
I don't think so. Yeah, there we go.
Oh, all right, herbs.
My nose will not leave me alone.
Oh yeah, that's right. There's also a zombie here.
It's dead.
But for how long?
Long enough.
Alright, now it's finally time to go fight the giant snake.
Yep.
Alright.
Oh boy, I hope I don't get poisoned, because that's even worse than when Jill gets poisoned. Can we not talk about fanfiction? What?
This is the stuff. This is the stuff legends are made of. Wait, where is the snake gone? Wait, what?
Can I get it? I got it. So you noticed that you noticed that Forrest did not come to help me. And also he did not die.
Yeah.
Wait, Forrest.
This way
Forrest,
you don't even get a shotgun.
Richard. Forrest is the zombie that runs after us. I get all these names confused, alright?
Yes.
Richard
Field will...
Richard did not come to help us, but in the process did not die. Not get eaten by the snake.
Yeah, but I'm gonna bet that he's completely useless anyway.
Oh, you're gonna see, there is a very special cutscene that only Chris gets with him. That is... one of my favorite. If anyone spoils it in the chat, I'm gonna ban you. I'm looking at you, Milt Johnson. No spoiling. That's not for me. Go away. Okay, I think I have all the masks. Yeah, I have all the masks.
Alright. Now we're going to the residence of evil.
Hold on. I still have the shield key, meaning there's a door. Right, it's Forrest's door that I didn't open, but I'm never going to, so I don't need this. Let's just go. Which way am I taking? Because I can't take the shortcut. Guess I'm just going around. Going back to the entrance.
Alright, now stay tuned for the adventures of Chris and Fia.
Yeah, we're almost done with the mansion part 1. Gonna go outside very soon.
Alright.
Did I explain why I don't want to play Resident Evil 0, or did I get interrupted?
Yeah, I think you got interrupted because I just heard that it was terrible. That's pretty much the gist of it.
Resident Evil 0, you play as Rebecca. Basically, it takes place before Resident Evil, slightly before, like... and you play as Rebecca and as another character, like a criminal or something, and... You basically have two characters to use at the same time. You can switch out between them. When you just play one, the other follows you. And there's a ton of puzzles that are just based on having a character stand in a spot and having the other character go in a completely different place. And it's tedious as all hell.
Oh boy.
Here's the mask. And also, another thing that is absolutely horrible about Resident Evil 0 is that there are no chests to store your items. What you get to do is you get to put them on the ground instead.
Oh boy.
And I did not like that. And he's dead.
Ouch.
Too bad that it was not 4S. 4S makes everything better so far.
This isn't 4S, no. This could not have been 4S. What is this? What is this thing shining? Oh, whatever.
Oh, handgun magazine. You should have picked it up, then you could have been able to throw it at Forrest's face.
This is not Metal Gear. No, I cannot take the shortcut, I have to go around, this is... Ugh. Actually, I might as well... Wait... Which path is the most zombie-free? I'm fairly sure this one will be. Jill's alternative costume are not nearly as funny. Because one of her costumes is basically her costume from Resident Evil 3, which is like a tube top and a miniskirt. It's just...
Why?
Because Capcom. I forget what her other costume is, but she has like big, big bright orange glasses, like, you know, construction guy glasses or something. I don't know. It doesn't make a whole lot of sense. Well, we're out of ink ribbons, or are we?
No, that's
not an ink ribbon. It's just a file. Someone posted the costume in the chat if you really care to know about this.
Ah, why?
Because, I don't know.
That doesn't even look like a thing that somebody will be a soldier or whatever
She's
would
a police
wear.
Officer, and...
But... That's not a license to be dressed...
No, I know. Resident Evil 3 starts, like, she's not, she just starts in her apartment, and, like, the town is already overrun, so I guess she's not in her uniform at the beginning of that game because of that, but it's still kind of fan service-y.
Yeah.
Amazing, I use a spray and I find another one. What is this? Oh, look at that. That's the
flash grenade.
That's Chris's defense weapon.
Alright, Forrest, we're gonna fight your grenades with our grenades.
No. We're not gonna use it on Forrest. I'm just gonna get attacked by a normal zombie just to show what it does.
Uh-oh.
Oh shit, why did I skip this? I should not have skipped this. Oh, whatever. We've seen this. Exactly... It's the same thing as with Jill. She gets radio call from the helicopter. But she cannot answer because radio is broken for some reason. I think that's the right way. There we go. Pick up the magnum because we didn't pick up the items. We don't need
Yeah, you should totally Yeah, you totally should have done the emblem switching puzzle with the Chris.
No. We have a rocket launcher, we don't care. Hey look, we're in a forest. I wonder what could happen in this forest.
So far, there's no forest which is happening. Oh, please tell me that the encounter with the dumb zombie still happens.
I'm fairly sure it does with Chris, but I'm not 100% sure. We'll see.
I just knocked down somebody. I'm gonna do my move only whenever he'll wake up.
Yeah, I still don't get that. No, I'm keeping this. Yep. Exact same thing. It doesn't even look like the monster hit us. It looks like Chris just decided to collapse for no reason.
Made out of tentacles.
We cannot kill the monster. It's impossible, but I guess it just... You can stun it, and it regenerates.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. I think Forest might be around.
No, forest is in the forest.
That's not forest.
It's natural habitat.
Oh yeah.
He's a fake. He's a poser. Not the real deal. It's not what the kids want nowadays.
What are you on about? Fuck you, bro.
Remember, every crow that you kill will make it so that you run in forest.
I don't think that's how the game works.
Ah, goddammit, now I just want Resident Evil to start featuring crows wearing bombs on them.
Actually, I said something wrong. That cutscene I skipped was just, well, it was someone telling us about the monster we found in the mansion. It's not the one with the helicopter. I am wrong! Though I don't think it's... Like, with Jill, it was Barry warning us to not go to the forest. I think when you play as Chris, it's Wesker who warns you?
Yeah, most likely.
There we go, that's the one with the helicopter.
Come in! Does anybody hear me?
This is Chris! Brad! This is Chris! Brad! Damn! Thing's broken.
Damn.
So, is it going to be like the other playthrough where he's gonna say the same exact thing?
Dog, leave me alone! No, I'm fine. No damage.
What the fuck? You got eaten by two dogs, you shot yourself point blank with two grenades, and you're fine?
I think the dogs are just there to scare you. They're not actually a danger.
See, whenever they just bite you, it's fake blood.
Oh, Whatever, the water empties, we've seen that.
I can hear the sound of a waterfall in the distance. But was there also a game mode like this in the original, or it's something that has been added in the remake?
Well, I think the original actually gave you the option to choose and maybe not have the zombie that kills you in one hit, or kills you when you shoot it.
Uh-oh.
Hey, Crow. Oh, shit, I missed it. No, that's the ground, Chris.
Use is winning! So, what exactly is use?
What? No, US? People in the chat are talking about football or something.
Okay, so it's the United States of Europe.
Some green herb.
Right, we're entering poison country.
Okay. Do I have a pen? I do. And paper. Oh shit, right. That's the thing that happened. Oh crap. I stepped into it, of course. Right. So. This iris is red.
Hey Chris, you totally should partake into the harm wrestling tournament and get rewarded with a huge butt.
What
are you talking about? I like the timing of it all.
This eye is orange. Red is 3. Orange is 5. And the other one is green, which is 6. It's always green. This is how you solve puzzles!
Solve puzzles with the power of a butt.
A notebook, actually. Bandage with blood. What do you think... What kind of, story do you think Bandage with Blood is?
I don't know. Maybe it's like a medical novel or something.
Oh, maybe.
It's like whenever medicine will go horribly wrong. So essentially it's like a fan fiction of a surgeon simulator.
It's like Dracula General Practitioner. What if Dracula was a surgeon?
Bone the thread! I don't know, okay.
What are you talking about?
I don't know.
I'm gonna put some items in the thing.
Blood red. Blood red field.
You are easy to amuse.
Yes?
Okay, I'm just making sure.
Oh, fuck yes, we got saves.
Yeah.
And I will save my game with the color of blood.
Oh.
Butt McButt.
I don't have any other, okay. And I suppose... How many things do I pick up down there? No, I don't think that's... I'll pick it up later. Whatever.
Oh yeah, but also, shouldn't you open the first aid box?
Whatever.
Albert Esker.
What is happening?
I'm 5 years old.
I know. Aren't you turning like 6 years old next week?
Yes. And we have our tentacle proof box.
Yay. No, don't read that. And look at that, no cutscene about Barry being weird, because Barry is not in this playthrough. Hold on, bathroom first.
Oh yeah. That's where Barry was. He was taking his bath.
Funny you should ask that, Clawblade. We're going to fight the plant the other way, not the way in the LP, but not for the reason you think. Is that gonna be Forrest? No, that's not Forrest. Okay. No, Chris! Wrong way! You idiot.
I want...
He's supposed to auto-aim. What the fuck? You massive dickhead. I mean, I'm not saying that wasn't completely my fault.
Whenever I face danger, I always have to go take a bath.
What are you laughing at now?
Well, we were asking for it.
Oh, fuck off.
I love you next time.
No, get out. Get out. Get out. Ban him. Forbade him.
No, I'm not banning him.
I only have half my health.
I'm so gonna buy him a drink next time I see him.
Right. I'm not gonna get poisoned, it's fine.
You know you had a care spray, you had a spray, right?
The spray gives more, I'm only gonna use it if I'm in the red. Come on, I have to be efficient here.
We're gonna have to be efficient in our hubris.
What, I can't kill the zombie before it comes down from the ceiling?
It's not a zombie, it's a hangman.
Okay, psych. I think the key I need is just in the bathroom, and in the actual room there's just the self-defense gun, which is useless.
Oh, you totally have to use it.
Nah.
Hell, maybe New Game Plus, the survival gun, will have, like, unlimited bullets.
Nah. Let's get out.
Alright, and now we have the car key.
A literal virus.
Oh, and you have 10 minutes to figure it out while you're being attacked by JPEGs that appear in your face.
You also have to, attack bacterias with your tiny, tiny, microscopic scalpel.
Yep. With your tiny hands.
And then input a really long code backwards or something.
Apparently, B-Man 2288 says that apparently this is the turning point in Forest mode.
What do you mean turning point? He's not gonna appear anymore?
Well, I guess he's not gonna bother chasing you around the other parts of the game.
I mean, I guess... the mansion is ideal for him because there's a ton of corridors where they can easily make him appear without making it completely impossible for the player to avoid him. In the residence, though, not really. I'm guessing we just probably won't see him until we actually come back to the mansion.
Oh boy, trigger warning, box pushing!
Oh, are you... do you have a... box trauma or something?
I have box traumatic stress syndrome.
Okay. I'm sorry.
Too bad that Forrest was not here. He would have made this room a lot more interesting.
Like that.
Hey, you know, Chris, you could jump if you had the will to just do
just
a jump.
Swim.
Which is... no, I can't swim. There might be deadly zombies in the water.
I mean, I suppose.
I mean, we just got to the box pushing part, and we already lost viewers.
Oh, I don't know. I don't check that. I don't care. I'm doing this for you! I think what I love about this box bridge is that, you know, when you push the boxes in, they have a little inertia, they bounce up and down because water, but when you walk on them, it's just completely solid.
No, that's because this pond of water is as tall as the boxes.
That doesn't make sense, psych. I'll pick it up. That makes literally no sense.
You know that's my forte.
Okay, psych. Watch.
Uh-oh.
Richard! Chris! Chris, stop! No! Richard.
What the hell?
So yeah, saving Richard with Chris is still pointless. He gets killed. He gets killed by the shark.
Oh my god, that was the best. Holy shit.
Oh shit. Why am I moving so slowly? I feel like... I don't want to.
Oh yeah, by the way, if you go in this room before you get the key, does you just end up dying if
probably,
you make it to the room?
This is a huge mistake to do that. I mean, you can just get out, but you, like, the very first time you play the game, you won't know that. You won't know that you need that key. So this is a little bit of a dick move. There is no first aid kit here. Oh well.
Uh-oh.
Yes, let's pick up that map. Very important.
Oh, fuck yes. Map of the Aquaring.
Okay, so... I remember how to...
You're not gonna drain the water on our watch!
Maximum safety. Alright. Release the safety. Engage the pressure shelter. Holy shit, is this going faster because it's hard?
I guess.
I'm fairly sure it shouldn't already be at 30%.
Reaching 50% of
pressure. Holy shit, it's already at 50. Shit, no, valve number 3. I'm pressing buttons too fast.
Activate emergency drainage system immediately.
This what? Segment of the game is slightly efficient.
Nothing happened, okay.
Oh, maybe the button that you have to push changes depending on the playthrough?
Maybe.
In which case, congratulations, game designers. You did your homework.
Every single time I played the game, it was number 3, I think. I don't know anymore. I'm having doubts.
All right, that's okay. We still did it.
This was Strel's fault.
Water has been completely drained.
Wait a moment. What is that?
Yeah, that's where we're.
One cares.
I don't know. I don't think so far we did a good job out of saving anyone.
Yeah, I mean, well, we saved Richard, but he was dumb enough to come here.
Oh, shotgun.
You can't save everyone.
Alright, now time to kill Mother Shocker.
I don't suppose you've been watching Niggurath's LP of Disaster, Day of Crisis?
Nope.
It's amazing. It's...
Oh, okay.
He has... I know you find... I know you personally find Niggurath boring, but on this LP he has Geop and Panzer as guests. So I don't think you'll find it boring.
Holy shit, he has guests other than Deceitful Penguin. Holy shit.
I keep telling you, Niggurath is not a bad person. Anyway, you should really watch it because it's amazing, and shut up about Niggurath being boring.
He's boring!
No, also, if you're Chris, this is where you get the assault shotgun.
Okay, it's the assault shotgun too, nice.
Instead of, getting...
Yeah, with that said, you still get way later.
Yeah. Okay. So, we're done with this place, we will never have to come back here again.
Alright, and now we're done with the quarrying.
Yeah, forever.
Okay, so what was next to do? I don't remember what was the next step.
Killing the plant.
Oh, alright. Wait until we're back to the mansion. I really miss Forest.
I may just stop the stream after the plant, because I'm getting hungry.
Oh, that's okay. Also, damn T-Virus, which is making me cough.
I open this.
Grenades! Oh yeah, that's right, it's B-City.
Yeah, give me the... thing. I'm curious. No, you can't. Okay. Wanted to check! Someone asks, can you just use the spray in this room? Why do you have to go around? Well, if you try, Chris is like, fuck no.
Yeah, we're gonna send the entire swarm against you.
They wound me? No, I'm fine. And we pick up the map to uncover the hole, but if we do not examine the hole, they don't actually attack.
Yep. We're just gonna assume that there's a beehive right next to the place.
Well, we have the map, so it makes sense. We have a good sense of orientation.
I don't need to read a map. I'm just here in order to kill.
Alright. Hold on. I forgot to pick up the fucking book. I'm sorry.
Oh yeah, that's right. I think it's in our safe box.
Yes. It's in the safe box. I forgot to bring it.
Does the map tell you where Forest is? I hope so.
That would be nice, but I don't think so, no.
It's like you just see a random dot getting stuck on every ladder or every single thing. Like, I want Forest Vision to be a thing in games from now on. In fact, once this video will be done, I'm probably gonna go play Mario Kart 8, and I just wish that the blue shell was replaced. And I just wish that the blue shell was gonna be replaced by Forest exploding in your face.
I want a Wii U. Why do you guys all have to buy a Wii U and play it without me? I'm so lonely.
People eventually got me with all of the talk about Mario Kart
Give
and all sort of things.
I need a Wii U. I need a Wii U.
Well, you could. Yeah, you could go and play the Wii U at this house.
First of all, it's not a house, it's like one room. An apartment.
Oh well, his home.
I don't know why I'm saying this. And I don't want to bother him. He has like work hours that are completely different from that do not coincide at all with the way I spend the day. Alright, six. That's six.
Alright, 666.
Three. That's five.
And the only thing which right now is not really making it so that I'm using my Wii U too much is right now I cannot get it to be plugged on my speakers because they're kind of hella weird.
Alright, so, we're Chris. When you're playing as Chris, you get all the clues to create the chemical, but if you actually try, Chris is like, I don't know much about this chemistry stuff, I'd rather not do this.
Okay!
So you
no,
cannot
you have no
actually...
choice but to fight the plant.
Yes, you're forced to fight the plant, mano a mano. Well, I mean... Oh, wait, what? I forgot to do something.
Did we forget to pick up a key?
Oh, under the beehive.
Oh, yeah. Right.
There we go. Yeah, that's the key, okay. What else,
All right.
What else do you have on your wee-woo?
The other games that I have is Super Mario 3D World, I got Wind Waker HD, and I use my free code, the thingy, to redeem a new Super Mario Wii U.
I am so jealous. Oh, I forgot to bring a save ribbon. It could have been useful. Do you still get the book that tells you all about how to make the chemical, but Chris just can't deal with this shit.
Even after reading about it.
Look, it's just... He's not a nerd, okay? He can't do this.
I'm gonna surround you with all of the lore, but you're not gonna be able to understand it.
He's an action sort of guy. He doesn't... You know...
Also, yeah, was Mario Maker that game that is like doing Mario Romax, except now it's legal?
Yeah. Oh shit.
Oh yeah, that's right. I'm so getting this.
Ouch. Thank you, plants. So it occurs to me, I have one health spray, and I have not tried to fight this boss in years. I do not actually remember... Oh, it's dead.
Oh, okay. Wait, one shot?
Well, I do have the rocket launcher.
Oh, yeah, I guess.
It does kill pretty much everything in one hit. I was afraid that would be weird, because, I mean, you have to shoot the plant when it's opening. It's... whatever. It's a boss fight.
But even then, if you climb on top of that place, can you even get hurt by the plant?
Yeah, there's like... tentacles and shit everywhere, I think. You have to be careful. Yeah, helmet key.
Alright, time to say hello to the hunters.
Yay, cause forest wasn't bad enough.
Also, we're gonna go meet back our favorite friend! Yes!
You okay?
Oh.
Yeah, it's dead.
I didn't know you liked Rebecca so much.
No.
Richard. He's... gone.
Oh. He's being all... Oh, Forrest is gone, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
It's like, why did you let him leave?
It's my fault. I should have watched out for him.
I found a pharmaceutical room. I think I can come up with something useful.
Don't change the subject,
yeah, sure.
Rebecca.
What will you have even done?
I'm glad you're still okay.
Why are you changing the subject? Damn, this game is dumb.
Oh my god, she's the worst.
Just whatever. They're all dumb. So I think it's the same thing as in the other room. She can heal you, except at this part of the game, I mean, we're done with the resins, so what's the point? I mean, I guess...
This room is equipped with all sorts of medical supplies.
We did just fight the plants, so... I guess it's a good way to heal from that,
yeah,
if you don't cheat like me.
Thanks.
Oh, she can make the G-Volt, the V-Jolt, if the plant is still alive.
But even then, do you still have to end up fighting the thing? Wait, she crying while she's treating your wound?
She is crying, I think. I think that's what the actress is trying to convey. I'm not sure. This acting. I guess, I've never tried to just go in, see the plant, and get out, but I guess, apparently people are in the chat are saying you can make Rebecca make the G-Volt. V-Jolt. I keep saying it wrong.
The G-Volt.
Wesker?
Chris, you're alive.
My words exactly. Where's Jill? Thought you were with her.
Yeah, I know. Separated.
I see. Anyway, we better find a way out of here before we turn into zombie food. Got any suggestions, Wesker?
We should get a better grip on the situation. There must be areas still to be explored in that other mansion.
Do you have a suggestion, Wesker? We need to get a better grip.
Check them out one more time. Continue my investigation here.
Sure thing.
Sunglasses.
Alright, we should split up again. It worked out really well in the past.
Well, obviously, yeah. That's how you do it. There you go. Man, look at these shoes. Wesker. Or Wesker, you dummy.
I wear sunglasses at night. I don't need anyone else.
Is this... I guess I should at least walk back to the mansion.
We need to end this video the way it started, with us shooting Forrest in the face.
Oh, fine, I'll walk back to the mansion, whatever.
Oh, and I know, the last thing to do, we shall take our survival knife and try to kill Forrest with it.
No, I doubt it'll work. It'll make him explode, somehow.
Ow!
This is Brad. If you can't answer,
see, that's the second helicopter scene.
Krista, Brad.
I mean,
can you hear me?
Helicopter.
Brad.
Okay, yeah, he also forgot that the radio's broken.
Also, he remembers quicker than Jill. Jill
yeah.
spent like 5 minutes on the radio. Oh wait, this is broken.
Yeah. So, are we going to get like a third scene where she's gonna go, alright, I should contact Brad on the radio!
Whoops.
Nice shot.
Yeah, I'm great at this. Now that's for later.
Oh yeah, we didn't get here yet in the LP, I think.
Oh yeah, no we didn't. Spoilers! There's a thing there.
No kidding!
I should probably edit that video and send it to you, because I'm gonna need to, upload it soon.
Oh yeah.
Oh shit. Oh,
welcome back to Snake Country.
We can't stop here.
Oh, hi, Miss Forrest. So far, he's my favorite character in the game.
I don't miss him.
It's like, so far he's got the best character development.
Okay. Sure.
I mean, you can clearly see a huge progression in his story arc.
I don't need that. No, I want to read
gunshot.
The message. Chris, come on. Use these shotgun shells to protect you from that monster that cannot be heard by gunfire. Thank you, Wesker. You are such a pal.
I just imagine for a second that the memo will just say, hey, if you stop trying to pick up the shotgun shells, you will be able to read my note, asshole.
Okay.
There, I don't need any puny doors.
Goodbye. Not dealing with any of your shit.
Right.
Okay, I think that's a good stopping point.
Yeah, I guess. After all, I'm not sure we're gonna see Forrest ever again.
What's the point?
Yep. It was my only reason to keep going forward.
Oh.
Now it's gone.
Oh well. I'm gonna stop here. I'm gonna make a stupid highlight. Maybe one day. I don't know. I have to not be lazy, which is a difficult thing. Anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. If you missed it, I'm gonna put that on the YouTubes. Oh, it is 2 hours long, Jesus. Okay. Thank you! Have a good night.
Good night, everybody.